92 to 95 FM, 810 medium wave, and on digital radio, BBC Radio Scotland.
Turning to the weather now, and generally dry at first, but some patchy rain will affect the south and east. Later, occasional rain will spread into southern parts. Elsewhere, it will generally be dry with sunny spells. There will, however, be some showers around and some drizzle will affect Shetland. The showers may become frequent in the east later in the afternoon. Temperatures will typically reach 19 to 21 degrees Celsius, but closer to 24 across Surrey. And that's BBC Radio Scotland News. More at 10.
Thanks, Amanda.
I never know what
good morning, it is Friday, August 21st, 2015.
Go up as many times as you want. I think this went up about three times.
I just don't know where the end of the tape is. I'll probably become... No. I might as well just set it as my broken record, I think.
Now, this is where we really want to get a photo.
Probably me, I don't know the date.
No purple's there.
It's yours.
Purple's here.
No.
I don't want purple.
That might be a bit bright. Dang it, it's brand new, I wanted to use it.
That's nice. Yeah. Really
well. And my smoothie, because it was the fastest thing.
Yeah.
But it was a job in Christmas. It's running from house to house.
How's
the flips now? I'm sitting on 84, so I'll charge the rest of this.
It's just not looking quite right.
And it will be like going jeans and t-shirt actually.
Rock up.
I did threaten that to Hannah. She said, what are you going to wear, Mum? And I said, I thought I'd, you know, do jeans and t-shirt. Yeah. And she just
happy.
And I went, new ones?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I'll just move this chair and I'll sit beside you.
Oh, wow. Hey. That's so beautiful.
Yeah, looks good.
Oh, mm-hmm. Awesome.
Can I put hairspray in your hair? Could you put it in place, please?
No. We all have hairspray. All of us have it.
Okay.
You should have it too.
We watched it the other day.
Well, not the other day. It's when I was in America.
Remember I was saying, I find it really relaxing. I think I would freak out. I would actually lose it. I would never talk to them again.
Yes. Oh, I.
Yeah, that's the way it'll go.
Sorry, what? Do you need anything else taken up other than that?
No, I think it's just those two.
Just these two.
It's okay.
Thank you. Know what it's like.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sorry. Right, that's to go up to the hotel.
I mean, it doesn't last as long as, like, say, the Beauty Blender one. Mm-hmm. But the Beauty Blender one is £30, so I'm like, I'll go with the £5 one.
Yeah.
Stop with the questions.
Hey, careful, Rachel.
Yeah.
She's got bare feet, by the way.
She's just been like so excited since then because she's actually understanding it a bit more now.
Yep.
Nice. I'm not looking at all my messages on my phone because it just.
I know.
Yeah, that's the wedding book.
Everybody
too. I'm going to take over here, Rachel. We can read it. It's more relaxing. I could get my hair done all day, every day. Will I go upstairs and put this on? Yeah. And then just this. And close your eyes. Okay, good. Yeah, what did they say when you gave them to the guys?
They were cool.
Half soul.
I smudged
it all
over my face. I was like, oh my god.
I thought you were the small one first.
Hello there.
Hey. Oh, there you go, and I'll go and get the
bag. Thank you.
Cheers.
It should be.
Oh my god, this is so exciting.
Is she?
Really? Really?
Yeah, he's really allergic to the.
Oh, perfect.
Okay.
She's just trying to jump in the photo.
Okay. I've got them here. Handier. Do I need to put dry shampoo in it first? It's a bit greasy.
So,
it's
not greasy. It
doesn't even look
there
greasy.
There you go, if you need it for later, just pop it there.
Thanks.
Well, do you want some water, Hannah?
Stay up there.
Would you like anything to eat, Hannah, while you're sitting down
I think I'm good for just now.
You sure?
I'll give you that for just now, yeah. Thank you.
So that's so you should get a flop face.
Yeah.
You should get what you asked for a flop face.
Yeah, so.
They'll get it fixed.
Yeah. What time is it actually?
Yeah. It's 11:30.
There was a Prosecco.
It doesn't matter, just as long as you go in front of him. I sit down onto
no shoes.
It's like one of them gnomes talking again, isn't it?
They were mean to me because I was taller than you guys, huh?
Who's taking the photo?
Is there another one there?
Is there another one there? The Porgy one, right, sitting on the
back. What are we on?
I'll put my heels up when we're going to
Porgy.
Did they get all the last minutes, but it's done, did they, in the end?
What is stop stroking your spot?
I know, I know.
It's rather disconcerting, then.
Transporter, is it?
Taxis, as far as I know.
Taxis.
That's absolutely stinking.
It's me, yeah. It's nice.
No.
I've got my backup reserves.
I'm hungry as well.
Hungry as well.
Do you want me to give you a couple of sandwiches?
Oh, is there?
All right. That's
fine. Take it. You take it. Whichever.
You take it.
Just because I'm...
People need a job sometimes. You don't get a job
tonight. And then she's driving tomorrow and then probably when we come back out. Because through the night, she's really late. Through the night-ish. So, and then when we come back, we arrive back in... just before midnight.
Hello. Hello, hello. You want to join us? No, I
Richard, the Auntie Margaret's wanting you to take some photos on her phone, please.
We'll put some pictures round by here. Some pictures for me, thanks. Mark, me and you and your
dad. Huh? The Mark already said his man.
Oh, Dan.
Well, after one service, did you not do one each?
No,
one for two. But like,
as long as everyone knows that, then that's alright.
I need to get my things falling down again, man.
Tie them, because he says that, like, if you feel the numb, if your leg starts getting numb and stuff.
Yeah, I did. Someone's next to the prom.
I'll stand next to the really.
I'm definitely going to.
You can't get many people in with my hat. I'm sure.
You're probably going to go with.
Yeah.
You know, you're
nervous.
Were you
really? I'm excited. I think the nerves will start when it's quiet. I mean, waiting for it to arrive. That's when I'll be like.
Yeah.
Good, weren't they? Should we go into the church, guys? Smile.
That's nice. I like your flower.
It's cute, isn't it? Go on, we'll go in. Too many people looking at
me. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
You must be Hannah's size.
Like 18 vodkas.
And you won?
No, I got beat. No, I got beat. So, I know. I'm playing, it's the thing is, I'm playing well on game beats. That's all I can play.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I know.
Is it bad on that?
I'll not ask you to do that to me.
Keep our hands
on. Right. Good luck, girls. Okay.
I'll be enough room for you up here, I think.
Oh.
Yeah.
See you.
Nice seeing you. Yeah. Everyone will be watching their rowing as well.
Is that? Well, that your one's turned. So is yours. Is mine.
Oh, this is so exciting now. Watch for Grandad and Auntie Hannah.
At least it's actually quite a nice breeze. So does the gems face the front, don't they?
Yeah, it's a circle gem.
Is it, how do you...
It's like that.
Okay.
Let's go.
Okay. I'll go first.
Yeah, you go first.
Let's sit back.
Yeah.
Second.
I'm delighted to welcome you all here today to Nesbank Parish Church to celebrate the marriage of Hannah and Mark. Can I just ask you to double check that you've switched off your mobile phones? And also to say that there's to be no photography other than the official photographer throughout the duration of this sacred service. At the end of the service, when the new husband and wife have proceeded down the aisle, I will ask you, the congregation, to remain there for a few minutes and then to exit via that door. But I'll show you when we get there. But we are here to worship God and to celebrate the marriage of Hannah and Mark. The psalmist tells us, unless the Lord builds the house, the labourers build in vain. We have come together in the presence of God to witness the joining together of Hannah and Mark in holy matrimony. to share their joy and to promise them our love and our support. Marriage is a gift from God and a means of grace. In the lifelong union of marriage, we can know the joy of God who made us in his image, male and female. Marriage is founded in God's loving nature and in his covenant of love with us in Christ. In giving themselves one to the other, a man and a woman reflect the love which Jesus has for the church. Through his death on the cross and rising again, our broken relationships with God and with one another are forgiven and healed, and we are reconciled. Marriage is to be entered upon thoughtfully and reverently, and with a deep awareness of its sacred and enduring nature. In Christian marriage, wife and husband are called to live faithfully together and to love each other with respect, tenderness, and joy, sharing a home where they can build upon the foundations of trust and loyalty which they have already laid. Our Lord Jesus was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, he is with us now to enrich our love and to give us his peace and joy. So today, as Mark and Hannah become husband and wife, we are confident that this deepening of their commitment to one another will lead to enrichment and joy in their lives. We're now going to sing our first hymn, Give Me Oil in My Lamp.
Oh, thank you. Spit to hear you sing.
To ask Beth to come up and read to us from the book of Genesis.
Genesis power over the fish, the birds, and all the animals, domestic and wild, large and small. So God created human beings, making them to be like himself. He created them male and female, blessed them, and said, have many children, so that your descendants will live all over the earth and bring it under their control. I am putting you in charge of the fish, the birds, and all the animals.
Amen, and thanks be to God. Our second reading comes from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. It's that beautiful letter, passage of the letter that talks to us about love, and Sandra is going to read it to us now.
If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant. Rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
Amen, and thanks be to God for these readings from his word. Let us now join our hearts and minds together as one. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks and praise for all your gifts of goodness and grace. We praise you for your gift of love, uniting our families, blessing our lives, enfolding us all of our days. We especially thank you, dear God, for the love which dwells and grows in the hearts of Hannah and Mark, and for the happiness and trust that has led them here today. And as they now seek in marriage to proclaim their love, to confirm their happiness and deepen the trust and loyalty which they share, may your Holy Spirit descend upon them to sanctify their joy, to enrich their love, and to grant them your peace. This we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord and friend. Amen. Could I ask the congregation please to be upstanding for the marriage ceremony? Okay, guys.
Oh, sorry.
You face each other, darlings.
That's very sweet, by the way. Just saying.
Jesus said, this is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. Mark, we'll do your vow first. In the presence of God and before these witnesses, do you, Mark, give yourself to Hannah to be her husband and take her now to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, to be faithful and loyal to her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Hannah. In the presence of God and before these witnesses, do you, Hannah, give yourself to Mark to be his wife? And take him now to be your husband. Do you promise to love him, to be faithful and loyal to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
This is the bit of my struggle.
As a token of the covenant into which you have entered, these rings are given and received. God of steadfast love, by your blessing, may these rings be to Mark and Hannah a symbol of the vows that they have made today and a sign of their unending love. Mark, will you place the ring?
Sorry.
By this sign, you take each other to have and to hold. From this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as you both shall live. Mark and Hannah, you have declared your love for each other before God and this congregation. You have pledged that you will live together in Christian marriage, in the words of your promises and the symbolism of the joining of hands and the giving of rings. In the power vested in me, I therefore declare you to be husband and wife. In the name of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. Those whom God has joined together, no one must separate. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Amen. You may now kiss your wife.
Sign your dress again.
With the congregation, please be seated. I'm now going to invite Mel up to come and read to us from John's first letter.
God is love. Beloveds, let us love one another, because God loves from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. And this is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we might also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us and his love is perfected in us.
Amen, and thanks be to God. Let us pray. Gracious God, for the promise, for the hope, for the love of this day, we praise you and we thank you. We thank you for the love of Mark and Hannah's family and friends, which surrounds them today. May it sustain them both in the years to come. We remember before you, Lord, loved ones who cannot be with us today. And we ask you, Lord, that the gentleness of your blessing may be upon them this day and always. We pray for Mark and Hannah as they embark on this new chapter in their lives. Bless them, Lord, with the strength of your Holy Spirit, that they may build a life of joy and fulfillment on the foundations of commitment and love that they have made today. May they always remain open-hearted, courageous, and strong. Give to them, dear God, a generosity of spirit, a continuing deep understanding of each other, as well as a warm and loyal friendship. Grant that they may go forward from this day, delighting in their love for each other. May their love grow, and in time may it prove able to heal and to help, to overcome difficulties, and to bring peace and reconciliation wherever it is needed, so that all may see in them a symbol of your love, dear God, from which nothing can separate us and from which nothing can overcome. Be with them now and forevermore, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. We're now going to sing One More Step Along the World We Go. To you, deep peace of the flowing air to you, deep peace of the quiet earth to you, deep peace of the shining stars to you, deep peace of the Sun of peace to you, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you and all whom you love this day and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Was it? You've got another one.
Okay.
Hannah, congratulations.
Thank you. I haven't seen my parents yet.
They're behind you.
I know.
Coming down?
Yeah, but... Oh, I'll hold your hand in a minute.
Okay.
Stop.
Hi.
You okay?
Yeah.
Just going to see you guys and then... I think, yeah. Aw. Good buddy, you alright?
Did you have a wee tear?
Huh? No, I didn't. I thought I was gonna, like it fell on a wee bit, but then after that it...
My flowers are falling apart by the
way. I know.
So be careful.
We'll have to say about that. Hello, you alright? Oh, thank you.
It's just not working with me.
I have a bunch of mine going straight up in the air.
If you go back up them steps, stand just in the door, dash out the wind, yeah?
Right, we'll go up there, okay? Right. You want granddad?
Yeah, and then everyone just be like, standing here, just like,
do we go see her?
She's going in every day.
But no, we were like saying to Mark that he shouldn't worry about handling it because she's always late. But then it got to like almost half past.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He's improvising as only a guy would.
Better when it blows up, it's fine.
Yeah. You look absolutely
cute. My favorite babe. Yeah, this is so crazy. Like, yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Like, it's like a smile.
Told to take like paracetamol and stuff before so my cheeks didn't get too sore. Literally just like, I don't even think I've got properly nervous at all for it. I've literally been like, come on. And we were sitting in traffic, I'm like, come on!
I need to get there.
But it was like, it's so warm and so warm.
Does it feel real yet? Does it all feel a bit?
I don't think it does. I think it hasn't quite hit me yet. Are you guys going back in? So will we get? Are we meeting you up at the? Do you know what's happening? We're meeting you up there.
Yes, I think.
Okay. I haven't actually got seen yet.
I know. Congratulations.
Everyone will be grabbing you everywhere.
Yeah.
You've been thinking about it all night.
I know.
Okay, guys.
I'll get it.
Have a little kiss, guys.
Okay, you go that way, Lewitt.
Thank you.
You leave from your house, sure.
We went same place, went for Aberdeen. So I went for there and there's 12 of us. So we got off the train, went for the train in the morning, got off the train, went going for it.
And then, okay, that was good, yeah.
Yeah, it was pretty good. And then after that we just
where was your foot pool? What's that?
Everywhere, anyway.
That's going to turn into the middle. Ladies and outside toe towards me. This please. That's perfect. And hold the bookie right on top there. Fantastic. Well done.
I'm just sinking in. It's fine.
How close do you want him to get? You'll be in me in a minute.
How's my girl?
Can you come?
So is the face lifting yet?
Dad.
I know. I'm
going to
get my hat
on. 1, 2, 3.
No, my hat's gone.
You stop. How about just shut it up for
you? My hat is clunky.
Just stop talking.
No.
No. Okay, guys, that's cool. And Dad, we're
so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
I knew you were going to be, didn't you? Cheers.
I've got a bit confident
you're going to trigger for that,
no. I could only dream of it.
I'm still finding confetti.
You will.
Just pick someone and I'll take someone out.
Yes, someone's going to go too far on floor, Hannah.
We'll leave you to take Hannah.
Do our routine that we learned.
She looks gorgeous, doesn't she?
That's it. Here we go, 1, 2, 3.
That's quite worrying because you're off.
I know.
There's a hand by the end.
Welcome your new bride and groom.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to step forward to your cameras, the bride and groom will attempt to cut the cake.
So I'd really like to thank you all for coming. I know that some of you have come a great distance. So on behalf of Ian and Maggie and Ian, I'd like to thank you all for coming, some from quite close by, some from quite a distance. It's really appreciated, and we're so delighted that you've come to join us in this really special day. Maybe also just a moment to think of those who maybe for whatever reason can't make it here or they're not with us, so that we think of folk in whatever circumstance. And now I suppose I also have to think about Hannah. And well, what can I say? She's been a girl who has been active and on the go all her life. She has had a real energy for everything. She's energetic, compassionate, caring, infuriating at times. But above all, I am so proud to call her my daughter. Now I've got to rein it in. I'm sure that the wonderful and funny memories we have will just continue to grow and to build now that Mark and she have started out together. So, you know, some of those memories will be accidents. Mark, I can only say good luck to you here. You know, Hannah and her trips to A&E. Well, do you know, we've had probably too many. There's been collisions with dogs mid-air, sledging. There's been where she goes swinging on bars and then wraps her mouth around it. And we've tripped to the A&E again. So every year Hannah does something, whether it's growing up or then in skating. She has invariably done something, and every summer we would say, so have the bruises started yet? Because she would be out and covered in bruises, and that hasn't stopped because she's an adult. She just carries on. So Mark, good luck with the injuries that come. Yeah. So I'd like to welcome you, Mark, to the family. It is a real pleasure to now have you as a son-in-law, and I am sure that Ian is delighted to have another male in the family because he's been slightly outnumbered up till now, Unless you count the guinea pig, and I don't think that's really very fair. So, for the future, well, what can I say? Care for each other, respect one another, share, support one another, laugh often, and carve out your own future together and make it the most amazing life you can. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you to be upstanding so that we can toast the bride and groom?
Huh?
No, you sit.
All right.
Bride and groom. Bride and groom.
Ladies and gentlemen, your next speech, the groom.
I'd just like to say thank you to my new mother-in-law, Marion, for those kind words. It means a lot. So, ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, on behalf of my wife and I, we would like to thank you all for being here with us today on this special day. It's been quite an emotional day already so far. Even the cake's in tears. It's bad. I had to go in there. We are delighted that so many relatives have travelled great distances to be here. Some as far as Australia and New Zealand. And that means a lot to both of us. So thank you. So there are a number of people that we would like to thank, so please bear with and make sure that your glasses are full. Firstly, I know it's not been possible for everyone to be here with us today. We know that they are with us in spirit, most certainly in our thoughts and in our hearts. So will you please all join me upstanding and raise your glasses to absent family and friends.
Absent family and friends.
Now, who else to thank next, without whom I wouldn't be here today? No, I don't mean my best man and the driver, but my parents, the most wonderful mum and dad in the world. I recognise you both always do all you can to give me the best opportunities in life, and for that I'm extremely grateful. I know every bit of advice you ever gave me over the years have been to better me and to give me the best chance in life that anyone could ever have. I know that I have lived a very privileged life so far, and I can thank you both for that. You have always worked hard and have always given us, you have always put us before yourselves, something you seem to do with ease, and hopefully I'll continue to make you both proud. I would now like to thank you, Ian and Marion, for welcoming me into your family today. It seems a bit strange to say that, as you have both made me feel like part of your family for a number of years now. I don't think I could ask for greater in-laws. But I would seriously like to thank you both for everything you have done, not just to do with the wedding, but raising such a beautiful daughter and hun. I'm sure you will all agree that both my mum and Hannah's mum look very beautiful today, and they have both put a lot of time They have both put a lot of time and hard work into make this special day as special as it feels. We can't thank both sets of parents enough for your wonderful contribution to this wedding. And just a fact for everyone, did you know that between them, both parents have been married in excess of 52 years? Which surely is a toast in itself. So, sorry again, but can everyone be upstanding?
I'm going to run out of wine.
I know. I'd like to toast to loving parents. And Mum and Marion, we've got, me and Hannah both have a little gift for you. And I'd now like to say a big thank you to my ushers, Adam and Robert, wherever you are. You have both done a fantastic job in making sure everyone has been in the right place at the right time and everyone has been taken care of. Also, there is an unwritten rule that the groomsman should never look better than the groom. So I'd like to thank you both for complying with that today. The bridesmaids, Lauren, Robin and Samantha. You must all admit that they all look absolutely amazing today, and they have done a brilliant job in helping make this wedding as special as it feels. Also, I'd like to say a quick thank you to Lauren, the chief bridesmaid, for organising such a perfect hen do. And I know everyone had a great time, especially Hannah.
Yeah, we did.
So you're all getting a workout, but sorry, can you please be upstanding again? And raise your glasses to the bridesmaids. Right, I'm on the home stretch now, so I promise not to bore you for too much longer. To my best man, Chris, we have known each other for some time now, and even with me moving to the other end of the country, we have never lost contact, and you've always been there for me when it matters. I thank you for putting up with me, even when we worked together and also outside of work. I'm sure at times this wasn't easy. I'd also like to thank you for being a true gent and letting me beat you at golf, even though, obviously, I'm the better player. But on a serious note, most importantly, I'd like to thank you for being a true friend. And hopefully, you'll be kind to me in your speech. I know it's been hard making up stories and lies to try and be funny. And finally, but never last in my eyes, to my beautiful wife Anna, who I think you will all agree looks absolutely stunning today. I knew from the first time that I saw you that you were the one for me. And in church today, we chose to celebrate in front of our family and friends our love for each other. I know I'm a better person with you in my life, and hopefully you will think of me the same way once you know where we're going on honeymoon. I'm only joking. But I'm a very lucky man to have you by my side, and I will always love you with all my heart. Always. Ladies and gentlemen, last time, please be upstanding, and the most special toast of them all. To my wife, Hannah.
God help you.
Are you all right, darling?
Ladies and gentlemen, the best man.
Woo!
First of all, I'd like to thank Mark for that pile of lies he just said. Now, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, distinguished members of the Witches' Coven. I'm sure a few husbands will be getting a firm elbow in the ribs for that one. Now, before we get started, I just want to make sure you all know that my wife has been through this speech and removed all the offensive jokes and bad language. I'm literally left with this. So, if what's left is rubbish, it's absolutely her fault. I'm just saying, she's the one sitting there cringing just now. High step. Okay, so for those of you who don't know me, my name's Chris, and it is my honour and privilege to be here today as Mark and Hannah's best man. As some of you may know, it wasn't actually me supposed to be here today. It was supposed to be Mark's friend Callum, but Callum had work commitments, so I was more than happy to step up and be the second best man. I'm sure you'll all agree with me that all the girls look particularly stunning today. Absolutely gorgeous girls. And even Ian's scrub up, not bad as well. Now, given that this is my first speech, I was given quite a lot of advice by people, and the main bit of advice that stuck in my head was to make sure the speech is no longer than the groom can make love for. So that's it for me, folks. I've got at least another 30 seconds. Now, traditionally, the best man's supposed to stand here and tell you all embarrassing stories about the groom, about what happened on the stag night. And at that time, he assaulted the Puras and Pizza Box in Inverness High Street. But the fact is, Mark's more than able to embarrass himself, and I'm sure he will at some point. So I'll just leave that to him. So I've known Mark now for, well, since he was much shorter, to be honest. And he came to work at the restaurant with me, and he started as a counter boy. But after a few years, we took him through into the kitchen and attempted to make him into a commis chef. Now, I say attempted, because as far as I know, he still can't cook, so I don't know who got the ball on that one. But it was actually on the golf course we became close friends, and regardless of what he said, we played golf twice a week, and he just had his arse handed to him all the time. He'd even resort to dirty tactics, like when I was putting, he would start singing stupid songs. There was actually one time we were in a competition and with a guy that we'd never met before, a guy called Brian, and I'm standing in the middle of the 13th fairway about to take my second shot, and from behind me all I heard was this ruckus, that's all you could describe it as. Mark decides he's got bored with the golf and he's starting to watch Formula One on his phone. Or latterly, he would just try and annoy me so much before we even got there that I couldn't hit a ball to save my life. You know where this is going, don't you?
Yeah.
One Sunday morning, we were due to tee off at 10 o'clock in the morning, so I turned up at Mark's house, as I do, 9:45, I phoned him, Mark, I'm outside waiting for you, and he's like, oh, I've slept in, mate, I'll be right out. Now, any normal person sleeps in, there's somebody waiting outside for them, you might brush your teeth, wash your face, you're out the door. I could even understand a shower, not Mark. Mark goes for a bath. A bath. 45 minutes I was waiting outside. I would have been raging if he didn't smell so nice. So it's going to get a bit soppy here, folks, because after all, we are here to celebrate a wedding. A marriage of two people who want to spend the rest of their lives together. And I'd like to read to you a quote from that famous love story, Winnie the Pooh by A.A. Milne. Piglet asks Pooh, how do you spell love? And Pooh says, don't be silly, you don't spell love, you feel it. And believe me, folks, there's no such thing as a perfect marriage. I'm sure everybody in here will testify to that. I mean, this is as long as I've been allowed to speak in 13 years without being told. But having said that, if you stick together and get through it all and stand whatever life throws at you, you will get through it. And the rewards are endless because, after all, you get to spend the rest of your life with your best friend. I got my brownie points up there. So years from now, when you're going through an inevitable rough patch, just remember back to this day and remember why you married each other. And each time you look into each other's eyes, remember you never married the perfect person, but the person who's perfect for you. And also, statistically, the person most likely to murder you. And with that, folks, I want you all to raise your glasses. And wish Mr. and Mrs. Cormack all the best in the world.
Mr. and Mrs. Cormack.
Well done.
Thank you.
Good speech. Well done.
Well done.
Thank you very much. It's a joy to be with us all here today to celebrate the marriage of Hannah and Mark. Woo! But can we just share a wee moment to pause and to pray? Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we seek your blessing upon the hands that have produced the food that we are to eat, your blessing upon the hands that have cooked it, your blessing upon the hands that will serve us, and your blessing upon us as we celebrate this wedding today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm going to go to the next one.
It's just people making
chili and chocolate, chili and mango.
I just remember because I went in town with you.
Yeah. And you eat it.
Same as you.
Long as I stand.
Yeah.